been now with the long clearance, and that one is headed away by Herbert Dick, the Amazulu defender. Amazulu welcome back James Piri in their lineup, back from injury, and this afternoon captained by Norman Komani. As that flick comes through there, safely collected by goalkeeper Dominic Sithole. Norman Komani in a tussle for possession as James Piri controls it in midfield and finds Taurai Makukutu. Makukutu now to Master Masiku on the right. Getting past his brother Mtewa Masiku with a through ball that rolls out for a goal kick to Highlanders, and Tabua Kabini preparing to take the goal kick. It's Amazulu nil, Highlanders nil in this crucial Kasulaga Premier League match. Highlanders are needing maximum points, Amazulu also needing maximum points. Although Amazulu have a couple of games in hand, and they can still afford to lose this game and just win their remaining games and still clinch the championship. Ebert Dick now heads it away for Amazulu, looking for Makukutu. It's headed away by Amazulu as they are looking for James Piri. Amazulu this afternoon missing Vusumuz Nyone and David Mukandawire, who are away in India in the Afro-Asian Games. And Estrom Nyandoro has won a starting jersey, so has James Piri in midfield to partner Ronald Sibanda. Highlanders now get a throw on the left side with Beck Tembandoku. He's pushed out for another throw-in, still on the left flank, which Highlanders will be taking in black and white this afternoon, and Amazulu in their traditional colors, gold and black, playing here from right to left. And the referee Edson Kau just indicating there that that's a Highlanders free kick. Behind it now is captain Vic Tembandoku. Vic Tembandoku behind the free kick, just taking on the right is Richard Choruma. Comes with a free kick, is blocked well there by Herbert Dick to give Highlanders a throw in, still on the left flank where they've been initiating most of their moves, and where two brothers are facing each other, them Tewa Masiku and Master Masiku on that flank. Master Masiku for Amazulu and Mtewa for Highlanders. Both former Real Stars players, both started their career at Highlanders with the Highlanders Juniors, as Amazulu gets another free kick, which Herbert Dick will be taking on the right flank. Herbert Dick behind the free kick now for Amazulu. He finds his goalkeeper Dominic Sithole, who has moved from his goal area, and will dispatch a long clearance now. Ronald Sibanda in midfield has made a good comeback, especially getting a jersey with the national team. Dominic Sithole still wants to pump that one up front. Good flick now as they find Seji Baisandaka with an effort, and Thubelihle Nkomazana blocking that effort from Sandaka. Tricky dribbling wizard as he finds in the cross there. And that one is headed wide, but that's the trademark attack from Amazulu, where Norman Komane combines well with Seji Baisandaka. But on that occasion, it just went wide for a goal kick, which Kabini prepares to take now for Highlanders. And it's another goal kick, this time to Amazulu. We are still in the first half. It's Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. These teams are playing their league match number 12 since Amazulu came into the Premiership, and Highlanders have been doing well in the league meetings. On the other hand, Amazulu doing well in cup competitions. as now Amazulu come with a back pass. Dominic Sithole finding now Foster Chitema. Blind pass is taken away by former Amazulu midfielder Thomas Banda. Finds Ona Kombani to Choruma. Good defensive work from Amazulu, but some exciting play in midfield as now Highlanders find Kombani inside the box. Is Choruma. Kombani and was too slow there. Ronald Sibanda takes it away, and here now is Taurai Makukutu. Still Makukutu racing forward, finding now Norman Kombani. He lays it now for Ronald Sibanda, takes his time, but this should be a chance for Sandaka with his trademark bicycle kick, but he was offside there. Scored another spectacular when Amazulu blasted Kambuzuma at Luveve Stadium. It was another brilliant bicycle kick inside the box. On that occasion he was offside, but that's the attacking formation that Amazulu always use, at times using their wings, at times coming through the midfield with the likes of Taurai Makukutu, and this afternoon James Piri is back in it. Usually troubles Highlanders. In midfield now it's Choruma finding Gilbert Banda. Back to Choruma. Back pass now to Captain Bektemba Ndlovu. Ndlovu now exchanging the passes, but good defensive work coming from Estrom Nyandoro, who this afternoon is back in the starting team. Has been starting from the bench with Machindalo playing the anchoring role. It's now a free kick again to Highlanders in their own half, as we are still in the first half in this a big Bulawayo derby, league match number 12 since Amazulu came into the Premier League. And of the 11 matches they've played, Highlanders have managed to win 6, Amazulu winning 2, then the other 3 games were draws. But in terms of cup competitions, Amazulu have been better. Kelly with an effort that is served by Dominic Sithole, but did not quite handle the first shot there. And from the rebound, Kokeli Dube, Dominic Sithole with a fine save. And here now is Choruma. Master Masiku collects, finding Nyandoro. They find now Sandaka. Sandaka still with the ball, finding Taurai Makukutu. Makukutu now with a good pass to Ronald Sibanda in midfield, and they change it now to the left, where there is Foster Chitema slicing the cross. They've missed that one. It falls again on Sandaka. The cross is not a good one, although it falls out for a corner kick. Some poor communication there from the Highlanders defense, and poor anticipation from the Amazulu strikers, because that could have been a chance for them. As Amazulu get their first corner kick here at Babafield Stadium, and behind the corner kick is Foster Chitema. It's Amazulu 0, Highlanders 0. Amazulu with a good chance now for the deadlock to be broken here and take the lead. Foster Chitema behind it. Fine goalkeeping from Tapua Kapini. And that one is straight to goalkeeper Dominic Sithole, who finds Estrom Nyandoro. Master Masiku. Ronald Sibanda. Switching play beautifully as he finds now James Piri. It's still James Piri who's slowing down the game a bit and finds Foster Chitema with an effort. Not a bad one coming there from Foster Chitema, as he wanted to test goalkeeper Tapua Kabini. And just like Dominic Sithole, he will roll it now out of his goal area, Kabini. Thomas Banda, good touch as he finds now Gifluma to Thomas Banda. That one was always rising. But beautiful exchange of passes there in midfield, initiated by Thomas Banda. so far a fine game from him against his former team, Amazulu. Choruma in midfield. Ronald Sibanda winning that one. And Choruma winning that one again. Although there is a tackle. And it's a yellow card to Ronald Sibanda. And Sibanda seems not to be happy, still complaining at referee Dinkau for that booking. But indeed, it was a rough challenge. But I felt the argument by Ronald was that the referee had ignored Choruma when he went for that ball. So it's now a free kick to Highlanders, Bektemand Lofu behind it. It's Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. Richard Choruma is cleared away by Amazulu for a throw-in to Highlanders on the left flank with Tewa Masiku behind it. Estrom Nyandoro with a timely clearance for Amazulu to push it out for yet another throw-in. Tewa Masiku still behind it, still on the left flank, but this time inside Amazulu's half as Nyandoro clears and the Master Masiku collects now against his young brother Mtewa. Ronald Sibanda through ball now, finding Taurai Makukutu. And Choruma wins that one. Kombani now finding Gift Luma. And a good tackle coming through from Amazulu. Ona Kombani. Through ball for Choruma as they flatten the cross. That effort going over the bar from Gift Luma. So far, the Amazulu defense has shown loss of discipline as Dominic Sitole continues to issue instructions and organize his defense. He's coming now with a goal kick. Wasn't really happy with that clearance, Dominic Sitole, as the clearance comes through. Tewa Masiku forward now, finding Gift Luma. Tackle from Herbert Dick. That was Thomas Banda there. A rather crude tackle by Herbert Dick. And the referee will really have to try and have a firm grip on this one, because we're now seeing some nasty challenges coming through. And if he can control it straight away, the better for the game, as now Bektemba Nkiwane is receiving treatment. Looks like he was bleeding, but he has since picked himself up, and there was that tackle from Herbert Dick, and that's a bookable offense in my view. Although the referee has just ignored the booking, but he has awarded the free kick to Highlanders. Behind the free kick is Mtewa Masiku. Still in the first half, it's Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. Highlanders on top of the log, but Amazulu with two games in hand, and the Dynamos placed third, still with a chance also of getting the championship. And here is the breakthrough now for Amazulu through Nomen Komane in a tussle with the Thubelihle Nkomazana. And the youngster showing much confidence, always first on the ball with those tackles, as now Gift Luma beats his marker cleanly. But he pushed it rather far too forward and was now coming with rough play as well. And he needs to be composed, Gift Luma. It was indeed unnecessary there, as now Bektemba Nkiwane pulls it back now to goalkeeper Tapua Kapini. Kapini now with a long clearance. They find Mpokeli Dube on the right. Mpokeli Dube with a back pass now to Gilbert Banda. Another tackle coming through. The ref says that was a fair challenge. So it's a throw-in now to Highlanders, still on the right flank. It's in fact a free kick, and behind the free kick is Thomas Banda. playing against his former team, Amazulu. As he flies in the cross, it's cleared away by Amazulu. And a pick now by James Piri. Pressing through the middle, James Piri, that's where he's good at. Through ball now for Norman Komani. Komani flies in the cross, it's a low one. It's safely collected by Tapua Kapit. Thomas Banda involved in most of the moves for Highlanders as he finds Gilbert Banda to Choruma. Choruma now, Thomas Banda wanted to lay that one for Gilbert Banda, but the move was read well by Amazulu. Ronald Banda will dispatch that long one now as Choruma controls, chips it over now. It's a poor one from Choruma. It goes out for a throw-in to Amazulu on the left flank. And going for the throw-in is Foster Chitema, the left wing back for Amazulu. I'm sure Foster Chitema missing his other linkman on the left side, Fusumuz Nyoni. The two usually combine absolutely well on that left flank. As now Amazulu quickly take that free kick. But Thubelihle Nkomazana doing well to pick Ntewa Masiko, and he has beaten Master. But the cross is a poor one. And Choruma controls now in midfield. Good skill as well from him, finding Masiko. But Ntewa Masiko, the cross is not a good one. Ronald Sibanda picks it now in midfield, finding James Piri. He beats Thomas Banda. It's still James Piri. Slowing the game a bit as they try to initiate a move and launch an attack. And Temba Dovu coming through there, and it's Highlanders throwing. It's Amazulu throwing, in fact, and Master Masiko will take it now on the right flank. Still Master Masiko as he flies in the cross, safely collected by Tapua Kapi. And Giftlunga now is broken loose on the right flank. A timely tackle coming through there from Herbert Dick, a tough defender. He is Herbert Dick. And he wins that one again and finds now Foster Chitema. A beautiful skill from Choruma, finding Thomas Banda. It's still Ronald Sibanda taking that one away from Thomas Banda. And now Gitiza rolls it now to Estrom Nyandoro. Some exciting play in midfield from both teams, although Choruma has looked more enterprising in that midfield department. As now Amazulu come through with Foster Chitema. Gilbert Banda, Thubelihle Nkomazana with the clearance, and it's straight to Herbert Dick. That's where Amazulu have been good. Their defense has been disciplined, with Herbert Dick playing a crucial role in that defense. Ntewa Masiko. It falls now again on Makukutu with a through ball, and that one will fall on Tapua Kabini. Kapini now finds Gilbert Banda. Banda now with a through ball to Giftlunga. Lunga now to Gilbert Banda. Banda to Ona Kombane, and Amazulu take it away. And now they are trying to find Sage by Sandaka. The clearance from Temba Ndovu was a timely one, and a throw now to Amazulu. Master Masiko, Ronald Sibanda, finding Sage by Sandaka. Good skill. Sandaka now with a pass through one to Norman Koman inside the post, trying to shield that one. But scramble now for the ball. And the referee awarding Highlanders a free kick there in that scramble for possession, as Vektema Dov was on the ground. Norman Komani kept kicking, going for the ball, but the referee felt that that was rough play, and that's a free kick now to Highlanders inside the penalty box, and Tapua Kapini will be taking the free kick. Still in the first half, it's Highlanders 0, Amazulu 0. No goals in this local derby, the big Bulawayo derby, as Tapua Kapini comes with the clearance. It's headed away by Amazulu for a throw-in, which Gilbert Banda prepares to take. Almost a full house here at Baba Field Stadium, as Herbert Dick now clears. Nomen Komani finding Sandaka, that's where they are dangerous, through ball, but this time is a bit too much from Nomen Komani. And it falls on Tapua Kapini. The striking two of Nomen Komani and Serge Bai Sandaka is done well for Highlanders, for Amazulu up front. And it might be the trick that might undo Highlanders this afternoon, although they haven't struck that rich formula. But always a joy to watch when they are combining Sandaka and Nomen Komani, as Sandaka is the one that ball, but Amazulu clear well. And it's now a throwing now to Amazulu, Foster Chitema behind it. Sandaka turning very well, left footed, is still searched by Sandaka, and Thubelihle Nkomazana has done well there to shield it away from Sandaka, as Amazulu get a second corner kick of the match, 2-0 on corner kicks. Amazulu ahead, but in terms of scores, it's still goalless, but perhaps Amazulu can create something from this corner kick. James Piri usually flies dangerous corner kicks. He comes now with a corner kick. It's a dangerous one indeed, but headed over the bar by Nomen Komane. But James Piri back in the Amazulu team, and back with his beautiful crosses, especially from the corner kicks, as now Highlanders try to build it from the back. Big Temba kick is over, pulling it back now to Tapua Kapini. Out of his goal area now is Tapua Kapini, to try and launch and initiate another move. He finds now Big Temba Ndogo on the left flank. They chip it now, finding Tewa Masiku. Masiku with a good cross. It was not a powerful header there from Thomas Banda, and no problem for Dominic Sitole and Amazulu. So it's 25 minutes in the first half. It's Amazulu 0, Highlanders 0. As now Mtewa Masiku collects now from the left side. Ona Gombani in midfield, finding Richard Choroma. Choroma now to Thomas Banda. James Piri wins it. Ronald Sibanda trying to come with a searching pass, but Thubelihle Nkomazana always first on the ball. The young Highlanders defender combining well with Victemba Nkiwani in defense, and Gilbert Banda, who is the right wing back. Taking the throw in now is Gilbert Banda. That one falls on Komani. Ronald Sibanda has won that one through ball now, but again, Thubelihle Nkomazana always first on the ball, and Choroma is enjoying that midfield. He's been subject to rough tackles as well, but quickly picking himself up and coming with a free kick. A through ball now to Mkokeli Dube. And that one was already out. That's a goal kick. That's part of the crowd there, and sitting anxiously as Amazulu clash here with Highlanders. Victor Mankiwane looking there for Kokeli Thuba. It looks like that's a free kick against Herbert Dick, and he wasn't at all happy with that decision. So it's now a free kick to Highlanders on the right flank. Behind it is Bektemba Nkiwane. He flies in the cross. The goalkeeper has missed that one, but Master Masiku can clear now for Amazulu. The goalkeeper is still on the ground, and Master Masiku racing forward. He was tackled there by his young brother, Tewa Masiku. And that tackle there on the left flank is an interesting one between Master Masiku and Tewa Masiku, as now Dominic Sitole is receiving treatment for that challenge as he went airborne for that ball. I'm sure he was pushed there, and Amazulu will get a chance to organize their defense as Dominic Sitole is receiving treatment. Also, there is Felix Matsika, the Amazulu manager, and we wait to see how it's going to happen as we see the crowd there who are still waiting for a goal in this big Bulawayo derby. It's Highlanders 0, Amazulu 0. History has shown that Highlanders always meet win the second clash of the league encounters since 1997. In 97, they won it 1-0 here at Babafu Stadium. And in the 1998-99 season, they won it 3-1. And that was the cross, a bit of pushing there. And I'm sure the goalkeeper should have been protected there. And in 2000, they won the second meeting by 3-2. In 2001, when they won the championship, they won it by 1-0 with Charles Chilufya scoring. That's Jonathan Chikaponya, the Amazulu reserve goalkeeper, just warming up just in case Dominic Sitole won't be able to continue with the game. An equally good goalkeeper, Jonathan Chikaponya. And just talking about 2001, in which Highlanders won it by 1-0 here at Babafu Stadium. And last year, in the second meeting, that's that cross there, a bit of pushing. Master Masiku broke away there. And last year, Highlanders won it by 3-0 here again at Babafu Stadium. And so far this season, in their first league match, the two teams have played a goalless draw here again at Babafu Stadium. So we wait to see if that trend is likely to continue. Highlanders have dominated the league meetings, although Amazulu have been equally impressive or even much better in cup meetings. Dominic Sitole just stretching himself up now and seems to be feeling well now. And now it's a throw-in on the left flank going Amazulu's way. It's in fact a free kick. That tussle for possession between the brothers going in favor of Master and against Mutewa. As now Sandaka comes up front now for Amazulu. Thubelihle Nkomazana in defense there. And it looks like the referee would like that free kick to be retaken. Still on the right flank, and this time behind it is Esrom Nyandoro. National team midfielder will be taking the free kick on the right flank for Amazulu. It's Amazulu 0, Highlanders 0. Choruma now in midfield. Ona Kombani trying to win that one. He has done so. He finds now Gilbert Banda. Banda now finding Kokeli Thuba, but is cleared away by Amazulu. And Nomen Komani now breaks loose, finding Sejibai Sandaka. Couldn't get his footing right there, and Bektemba Nkiwane pushes it out for a throw-in to Amazulu. well, I was doubting the capabilities of these two young Highlanders defenders just before kickoff against a striker like Norman Komane and Sejibai Sandaka, but they seem to have held their own so far. But we still have some more minutes in the first half and the second half. We wait to see if they will remain consistent in defense, as now Ronald Sibanda prepares to take the throw in for Amazulu. Foster Chitema inside the box and is pushed out for corner kick number 3 to Amazulu, as now they are slowly surging ahead in search of an opener here. So this is another opportunity now for Amazulu. James Piri behind it. Just watch the crosses. Very good looking, the crosses that usually flies, but this time it's cleared away by Highlanders. But James Piri, one of the finest crossers of the ball on the local scene, as now Thomas Banda comes with a through ball trying to find Mkokele Thube. But Hepetik pushes it back to Dominic Sithole. Sithole now comes with a clearance. It falls on Komani. Lectembandov has defended, and here is Choruma now. That's a free kick. And the ref right on that occasion, because Choruma came with an open foot as he had lost that ball. Although the Highlanders fans thought it should have gone otherwise. But here is Choruma again in midfield now, finding Tewa Masiku on the left side. Through ball now from Kokeli. But that should be for Herbert Dick, always first on the ball and finding Master Masiku. Ronald Sibanda. As from Nyandoro to Ronald Sibanda, as Amazulu come through now. Another good ball now, looking for Komani with a shot there. And it wasn't a good one from Norman Komani, as Gilbert Banda now tries to find Gift Lunga, who has also struggled with this game. Usually plays as a left wing back, but in the last two games has been playing as a striker. And we have seen most of the play this afternoon being concentrated in midfield, where indeed we have seen some lovely touches from both teams. Especially from Richard, from both teams. Especially from Richard Choruma. He has been shining so far. Some pushing there from young defender Thubelihle Nkomazana. That gives Amazulu a free kick. Behind it is Foster Chitema. Foster Chitema with a good one, and it's picked now by Victemba Nkiwane. It's picked again by Choruma, fighting for possession, but James Piri has won it. It's still James Piri. Through ball now for Ronald Sibanda, but a bit wide this time, and Sibanda will pull it back now to Foster Chitema. That's a blind pass. And it comes now again to Gilbert Banda, finding Gift Lunga. Estrom Nyandoro first on the ball, and Highlanders have won it. Through ball now for Thomas Banda. But there are three Amazulu players, although he has found someone with a cross. Ebert Dick has defended well. And here they come now, Amazulu with Ronald Sibanda. It's now 35 minutes in the first half. It's Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. The battle continues here at Babafield Stadium in Bulawayo. It's now Ebert Dick. Tries to restart the formula for Amazulu, finding Ronald Sibanda. Sibanda now to Herbert Dick. Dick now to Sandaka. Sandaka now to James Piri. James Piri through ball, but Ona Gombani doing well there to win that one. And here is now Choruma. Through ball again now to Tewa Masiku, but Master Masiku greeting that one very well, as the drivers are fighting for supremacy on the far flank. Here is now the elder Masiku, Master, finding Ronald Sibanda. Highlander through ball now again to Master Masik on the right flank. Is Nkomani anyway in the center? That's where Amazulu will be dangerous. Master Masiko flies in the cross. Nkomani coming through. But Thubelihle Nkomazana was the first one there. And that one just goes over the bar. But Kapini not happy with his defenders. Although Thubelihle Nkomazana was first there. That's Tapua Kapini, the Highlanders goalkeeper. A good move by Amazulu with Master Masiko looking good on the right flank without cross, as Norman Koman was going for it. Young Thubelihle Nkomazana had already cleared. And the way those young Highlanders defenders are first on the ball, very good coming up with some basic defending, as now Foster Chitema controls. And that was a rough tackle. The referee waves play on, as for advantage. As now Highlanders push it out for a throw win, so that Ona Kombani can be attended to for that tackle. Seems to be in pain, that's Ona Kombani. And just receiving treatment in midfield for Highlanders, Ona Kombani, another player who has had an immaculate season, played a crucial role for Highlanders, more so with their comeback for the championship in the last few weeks. Just walking off the pitch now, Ona Kombani, and at any moment from now, I'm sure play will resume. So Amazulu now will just push that one out in a sportsman gesture, as Highlanders head position. They pushed it out so that Ona Kombani could be attended to. And Highlanders now will restart the formula. Tapua Kapini is out of his goal area and comes the long clearance. And Bektemba Ndlovu pushes it out for a throw in now to Amazulu on the right flank, and behind it is Master Masiko. Bektemba Kiwane pushes it out for another throw-in, as Amazulu still push forward as we are approaching half-time here at Babafo Stadium. It's Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. Yemakukutu now, Bektemba Ndlovu trying to win that one, still fighting for it, but has pushed it out for a throw-in. A throw-in on the far side, which Master Masiko prepares to take. Kombani back again to Master Masiko with a cross now. Thubelihle Nkomazana is cleared. It's now 5 minutes before the halftime. Still goalless. Gifunga now finding Kokeli Dube on the left. Kokeli Dube now finding Ona Kombani. Good coverage coming from the goalkeeper Dominic Sithole, as Highlanders were coming on the counter. So under 5 minutes now before halftime, it's Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. And it looks like the referee wanted that free kick to be retaken. And Tapua Kapini behind the free kick now for Highlanders. A crucial Kasilaga Premier League match. Kapini will come now with the goal kick. Straight to goalkeeper Dominic Sithole. Dominic Sithole now for Amazulu to take the goal kick. It's a free kick. I'm sure Gifunga was offside. Master Masiko on the right is getting those balls now on the right flank. Controlled well there by Dalrai Makukutu. Makukutu now with the ball. from Yandoro. Through ball now, trying to find. Challenge there is now the ball goes out for a throw-in. Dominic Sitole with a timely challenge there is now Highlanders break loose again with Gilbert Banda. Thomas Banda with the cross is still in play and it's pushed out now for a corner kick to Amazulu, rather to Highlanders, which is their first one. So now it's reading 3-1 in terms of corner kicks. And I'm pleased to say that we are now joined by former Highlanders coach and former Highlanders winger Matinda Ndlovu, who will be helping us with analysis as the cross comes through from Thomas Banda and is pushed out for a throw-in. Well, Matinda, it's been a battle in the first half, just under 5 minutes to go before the end. What have you made of the first opening 45 minutes? Indeed, even the balance at the moment, and the battle seems to have been in midfield more than anything else, and the strikers have not been getting those balls, although Highlanders now have won themselves a free kick, and Dominic Sitole just trying to organize his defense. It's a free kick now to Highlanders at a very promising position. And it looks like Tewa Masiku is behind it, so is Thomas Banda. Can Highlanders break the deadlock just before the break? It will be Tewa Masiku, flies it high. Still Highlanders there. That one is cleared from the line by Herbert Dick. Ferdinand Machindalo was also fighting for that one, and they push it out for the second corner kick to Highlanders. Thomas Banda now behind the corner kick. As now Thomas Banda now finds Gift Lunga. It's still Gift Lunga with the ball now for Highlanders. Finding Thuba now through ball for Kombani just on the edge of the post. The post comes through and is cleared away. Giflunga chest control, still Giflunga has found Thomas Banda. That one is blocked away. Highlanders attacking in the closing stages, Martin.
Thanks very much, Muzi. As you can see right now, is all Highlanders, no, they're trying to get that goal. They know exactly what they need. They need a win here in order for them to get a better position on the log. So it's all Highlanders trying to get that goal.
Yes, and now it's a throw-in to Amazulu on the left flank as Highlanders were mounting attack after attack in the closing stages, trying to snatch that goal. But good defensive work, much disciplined defensive work from the Amazulu team. Ferdinand Machindalo and Herbert Dick doing well in the absence of David Mukandawire. As now Foster Chitema prepares to take that throw in there for Amazulu, and they seem not to be happy with the match ball. Luke Masomero still issuing instructions from the Amazulu bench. Here now is Makukuto, took his time there, and it's taken away now by Highlanders. And Ona Bombani trying to find Mkokeli Thuba. The clearance is a good one, but Nomen Kumani just chasing there, and Kapini now will collect for Highlanders, finding now Tewa Masiku now to Gilbert Banda. Banda now to Ona Kombani. Kombani back pass now to Thomas Banda. Through ball for Gilbert Banda. And some lovely play from the Highlanders team as they try to flight in the cross, but Amazulu defend well. But good touches from Gilbert Banda as Bektemba Nkiwane raises his boot high there, and the referee awards a free kick to Amazulu. Well, the strikers have not had enough of the balls this afternoon. What has caused that?
If you look at the two teams, they are actually wanting to win the ball from the midfield. They want to try and win this game from the midfield. So not those accurate balls are being pushed onto the players. So as a result, the players seem not to be doing their job. And yet, you know, if the midfield has pushed those balls into space for strikers to chase them, then we'll see a battle of the strikers.
Right, and from the two teams, it will seem Amazulu have a much stronger strike force, the Highlander strike force, a bit of a makeshift strike force, as Giftunga now is being used as a striker up front in the absence of Chipotsoso. Here now is Machindalo with a through ball, now looking there for Vosta Chitema, and he couldn't keep it in play. Well, I was just talking about the Highlanders team, which has been changed in the last two matches. The defense looks very young now, and Giflunga is being used as the striker. Any comments on that?
Yeah, okay, all right. Gift Junior has always been a midfielder come striker, you know, from the time when I was coaching Highlanders. And I personally believe that that is his proper position. But again, if you look at it with Amazon having the better of the strikers in the afternoon, they've not taken as many chances as the Highlanders, you know. And as a result, it's not really about a good striker to get the goals. It's about how prepared is the team, you know, to try and win that game.
Well, those analysis, they're coming from Matinda Ndovu, as the halftime whistle has just gone here at Babafield Stadium. So the battle will continue in the second half. But halftime score here at Babafield Stadium is Highlanders 0, Amazulu 0. It's back to the studio.
I'm quite sure right now, Muzi, both teams have actually looked at trying to get an early goal within the first 5 or 10 minutes of the second half. I'm saying this just on a coaching point of view. I don't know what exactly the coaches have said to them, but we'll see as the game takes over, goes underway.
As we get underway here at Babafield Stadium for the second half, the ball falls now on Tapua Kabini, the Highlanders goalkeeper. It's Highlanders 0, Amazulu 0, and Highlanders goalkeeper Tapua Kabini now out of his goal area as he comes now with a long clearance. It falls on Gilbert Banda. Banda now with a cross, it's headed away by Amazulu. And here now is Serge Baisandaka, is Thubelihle Nkomazana with a clearance. The referee says that's a free kick to Amazulu. Thubelihle Nkomazana are just to have come with a rough challenge there, as now Amazulu get a free kick as from Nyandoro. Behind the free kick for Amazulu to see if they can take the lead here at Babafield Stadium. Esrom Nyandoro behind it. It's a poor effort from Esrom Nyandoro. The set pieces, both teams have not been using them this afternoon.
Yeah, well, Mozi, a free kick like that coming from a player of that caliber in Esrom, is actually not good enough for Amazon. Seeing to that is a national team player, he should have done much better than that.
Should have done much better than that, and now picking up the pieces is Highlanders as they try to find Kokeli Dube. And it falls again for a free kick. It looks like it's a free kick to Highlanders. They find now Victim and Kiwane. Kiwane finding Gilbert Banda through ball again for Kiwane. He has done well as he flies in the cross. Still Mtewa Masiku Mpokeli Dube still has the ball. And that effort just goes over the bar there from Mpokeli Dube. Was that a chance or it was a difficult angle?
Well, look, it was a chance to actually bury, in the sense that, you know, should he had actually put his mind together, he could have just taken that ball and leaned over the ball and put it much lower than what he did.
And now Highlanders have missed that one, but Tapua Kapini was always reading it, and he finds this time Victor Bandrovu is coming now on the break, the Highlanders captain. A timely challenge from Amazulu. Choruma turning very well, finding now the Temba Kiwane. Kiwane switching play now to the right flank, trying to find Mpokeli Dube. And a timely challenge and clearance coming from Foster Chitema to give Highlanders a throw-in on the right flank. Behind the throw is Gilbert Banda. That should be an easy one for goalkeeper Dominic Sitole. Victor Mandovo, captain versus captain, Norman Komani and Victor Mandovo. And Victor Mandovo getting that one away from Komani, and a through ball now to Gift Lunga. It's still Gift Lunga, and Herbert Dick has done well there in defense to stop Gift Lunga as they exchange the passes beautifully. That is Amazulu to build an attack now. Foster Chitema finding James Piri. James Piri in midfield for Amazulu, trying to change play. And Mtewa Masiku versus Master Masiku. And Mtewa Masiku had won that one. It's a throw-in. Thomas Banda back now to Mtewa Masiku with the clearance. And it's out of touch for a throw into Amazulu. Master Masiku now finds Herbert Dick. Still Herbert Dick now for Amazulu. Pumps it forward. It falls on Ronald Sibanda. Sibanda now finding Ferdinand Machindalo, the Zambian. They chip it over now. Good flick there, looking for Nkomani, but Victor Madovu defends well. But it's taken away now by Masiku, the fine cross. And Highlanders take it away. 5 minutes in the second half. Still Highlanders nil, Amazulu nil. As Ferdinand Machindalo pushes that one out for a throw-in to Highlanders. Gilbert Banda behind it. Finding Mkokeli Dube. Foster Chitema with the clearance. Looking now for Sandaka. Good defensive work from Thubelihle Nkomazana. As now Tapua Kapini clears for Highlanders. Choruma now picking it up in midfield. Gift Lunga finding now Mtewa Masiku. Masiku now with a through ball. Gift Lunga. And the cross was not a good one. Tight angle as well. And this time it falls out for a throw-in to Highlanders. Still goalless, still no chances been created for the strikers.
Yes, Muzi. As you can see right now what is happening with the both teams. They're playing with a lot of caution. As I said when you came in the second half, that no. The both teams, I think the coaches have told them that no, they must play with caution for the first 10 minutes or 20 minutes just to see what strategy the other team has got, so that, you know, they will go for that sucker punch. Whichever team is trying to get that goal to try and, you know, seal the play and play defensive thereafter.
As now Dominic Sitole comes with a clearance for Amazulu, falls on Sandaka. Still Sergi by Sandaka, left footed, finding James Piri. Line passes, diploma is collected now. Football looking for Mpokeli. He's trying to rush through. and the referee waves play on there. That tackle coming from Herbert Dick. The crowd is screaming for a free kick, but the referee waving play on. As now James Peary controls, but couldn't keep that one in play. And it's a throw in to Highlanders. As now Gilbert Banda prepares to take that throw in. Gilbert Banda with a throw in now for Highlanders, finding Kombani, but it's taken away by Amazulu through Foster Chitema. Cleared away by Highlanders. They head it forward, but that should be for Herbert Dick. Still in the air, headed away by Gilbert Banda, Ronald Banda. Too slow there, and Highlanders first on the ball in midfield. Here is now Kokeli Dube, trying to race forward with a cross, but it's a low one. Still Kokeli Dube. That one was misdirected. Amazulu create away. Mtewa Masiku now with another chance. Master Masiku has won that one. It's still Master Masiku racing forward. As a coach at this stage, would you think of changes for the two teams, or perhaps it's still too early? I can see Highlanders warming up their bench.
Well, and as far as I'm concerned, I personally believe. Oh, there comes the goal.
And Zamazulu have scored from the counter. They've scored a crucial goal there. A crucial goal for Amazulu on the counter. As we were talking about the changes, it looks like it's Serge Bai Sandaka who got that goal there. And Amazulu getting a very important goal from the counter that has silenced the crowd here at Babafuru Stadium. Most of the crowd, of course, cheering on Highlanders, but on the counter, Amazulu doing well to get that goal. It looked like it was a search by Sandaka, as now Choruma comes with a through ball. Giflunga now heads it forward. Ona Kombani back again to Giflunga with a shot that is safely collected there by Dominic Sitole. Sitole now will come with a clearance. So Amazulu getting an important goal, a goal that is likely to give them the 3 points and perhaps the championship, as now Mkokeli Dube comes through. It's a blind pass from him and is taken away now by Ronald Sivanda. Cleared forward now by Amazulu. Now they are looking for Serge Bai Sandaka again. And this time Thubelihle Nkomazana stops him. But still Amazulu are coming through. And James Peary coming with a nasty challenge there. And that's a free kick now to Highlanders. And Amazulu capitalizing on the counter-attack and getting a crucial goal.
As I was saying, Mozi, that you know, the teams had actually been, the coaches had told them both teams that, you know, look, play it with caution, and you know, when you get a chance, just utilize the chance. This is exactly what Amazulu has done now. And basically, if Amazulu are playing according to the instructions, all they need to do now is to keep their one ball and make sure that, no, because they don't have to play that class football, they just have to make sure that, no, that goal, they safeguard it and get those 3 points.
And get the 3 points and perhaps even add another one, as now Tapua Kabini will launch another attack now for Highlanders with a long clearance. Kokeli Dube trying to head that one forward. Thomas Banda, his effort speculative, straight to goalkeeper there, and the confirmation of the scoreline. 11 minutes in the second half is Highlanders 0, Amazulu 1. Search by Sandaka after 53 minutes. The two together with Norman Komani have been scoring goals, as Choruma comes with some fence work there and is taken away now by Taurai Makukutu. Makukutu now finding James Peary. Good defensive work from Bektemba Kiwane. Kiwane through ball now finding Gift Lunga. Lunga now with a cross as they find Thomas Banda outside the box. Still Gift Lunga inside the box there, and that one is safely collected by Dominic Sitole, and Amazulu now will their time to dispatch those free kicks as they are in the lead, as they try to hold on to that lead. Here is now Richard Choroma. Choroma now finding Kokeli Thube. It falls now again on Thomas Vander, too slow. Kiflunga has it. He pushes it to the right where there is Gilbert Vander. Vander now finding Kiflunga. Lunga now back pass again now to Bektemba Nkiwane. Kiwane finding Nkomazana. To Bektemba Nkiwane, and Amazulu pushed that one out for a throw-in. As Highlanders continue with their impressive play that has not produced goals, but that man, Serge Bai Sandaka, getting the goal for Amazulu after 53 minutes. It's headed away now by Taurai Makubuto, headed forward by Highlanders. Gombani now finding Thomas Banda. Through ball now, Thomas Banda finding Kokeli Thube, brings in the cross. Giflunga with the header. The goalkeeper is done well there to shield that one away from him. And he seems to have picked a knock. But Highlanders will attack. And Amazulu take it away. Here now is Ronald Sibanda with the clearance again to Serge Bai Sandaka. Again on the counter. Still on the left flank. That's where Amazulu are enjoying and capitalizing on these counter attacks. As they come with a shot there. Was on Makukuto, but Bektemba Nkiwane blocking that one, and they've made a mess of it, but Tewa Masiku is picking up those pieces. 1-0 to Amazulu, and the Highlanders continue to knock the ball around, but what count is the goals, and it's good for Amazulu.
Yes, because as I said, that you know, Amazulu are playing with very much caution, that you know, they need to make sure that they get these 3 points in order for them to have a better position on the log standing. And the Highlanders have not yet thrown it all, have not yet lost hope. As you can see that, no, they are now the better playing team. And if Amazulu are not going to be really careful about this game here, they might find themselves no conceding a goal or even going on to lose the game. You know, there's still much time. Highlanders are playing good football. They are actually attacking. And all what Amazulu needs to do is to safeguard and protect their goal.
But the Amazulu defense so far has looked good. It's playing with confidence. Highlanders are mounting on the pressure, but Amazulu still holding on to that Serge Bai Sandaka goal from the counter after 53 minutes. And play will stop as Highlanders are now making a change, and the analysis of this substitution, Tewa Masivu going out and Tamsa Ngavunda going in.
Mozi, I think this is a desperate kind of a move, and hopefully it works for Highlanders, but in as far as I'm concerned, it is a desperate kind of a substitution whereby, you know, they are opening up the defense, you know, much more wider than it was, you know, and it means that now Amazulu has to think seriously in order to try and get the second goal, which they will get because of that substitution, as far as I'm concerned.
Yes, as they try to open up more strikers up front, they actually open their defense, and Amazulu have looked dangerous on the counter as now Ona Kombani tries to come with a shot that is blocked for another corner kick. Desperate substitution according to our analyst Matinda here, and now Highlanders prepare to take their sixth corner kick. That's confirmation of that substitution. Now they fly the cross inside the box, Victor and Dogo, and is cleared away by Amazulu. Amazulu doing well now in defense to hold on to this lender lead. Choruma now for Highlanders, finding Thompson Mafunda. Back again to Choruma. Choruma now to Giflunga. That's a free kick now to Highlanders for that challenge on Giflunga by Master Masiku. And it's a free kick now to Highlanders. Giflunga behind it. Giflunga behind the free kick for Highlanders. The Highlanders and another Amazulu defender lying on the ground. This will obviously help Amazulu put away the pressure that Highlanders are mounting.
Well, Muzi, in normal circumstances, yes, it will. But technically and tactically, you know, they are actually making it open that, you know, the referee might go against their delaying tactic, and also that they might be making Highlanders much more stronger, you know, in terms of knowing that, you know, they are now scared that Highlanders playing, and if they have to pile more pressure, they might get that equalizer.
As the corner comes through, it falls now on Giflunga. Flights in the cross is cleared away by Amazulu. Ona Kombani with Thubelihle Nkomazana, but Sandaka has won that one and is trying to break through now, but couldn't keep it in play. Well, the changes that they made, it looks like Giflunga has reverted back to his wing-back position, and Thamsa Ngafunda is now up front partnering for Kelly Dube. Will that change things for Highlanders?
Well, personally, I believe that, no, they've just lessened the strength of their attack, and strongly believe that, no, Gift was the person that, no, is that type of a player who can harass a striker, who can actually run for the entire 90 minutes. Well, Thompson has been out of action for quite a while now, and basically he has to understand the play at the moment and adapt to the pressure that the Highlanders is facing in order for him to come into the game. And by then it might be after the 90 minutes. So really, I think they have actually lessened their strength of attack.
And for Amazulu, would you recommend any changes now, or they should just leave their team?
If I were a coach for Amazulu, I would really give faith to these guys that, you know, they've got the goal. And maybe towards the last 20, last 10, 15 minutes, I would then come in with those changes simply for tactical reasons.
So at the moment, Amazulu would be happy as Highlanders continue to fire the blanks in the second half here at Babafoun Stadium. Is Amazulu 1, Highlanders 0. Sergi by Sandaka with that important goal for Amazulu. A goal that will see Amazulu going back top of the log, as now Highlanders failed to pass the ball. That was Thompson Mavunda, like Matinda was saying, that he has been out for a long period of time due to injury, and for him to adapt will be quite difficult. But Amazulu will be happy with the proceedings as they are leading here by 1-0. As now they try to push the cross, it's an easy one again for Dominic Sithole. Dominic Sithole now will come with a bit of delay as he pushes the ball now for a throw in to Amazulu. Master Masiko behind it. Master Masiko takes the throw now, headed away by Bekemba Nkiwane. Controlled now by Thubelihle Nkomazana. Nkomazana now to Tafua Kapini. Kapini now with a throw ball for Bekemba Njoku. On the right flank this time as he tries to flick it. They are now looking for Mkokeli Dube and Dominic Sithole first on the ball. And will now take his time for the clearance. Tafua Kapini now controls it. Find Bekemba Njoku on the right side. Looking there from Mkokeli Dube, safely collected by Dominic Sithole. And Dominic Sithole has come with some poor distribution as a goalkeeper, and Amazulu, basically what they need now is simply another goal, and then that's when they can start defending.
Yes, Mozi, as I said, that, you know, as you can see now, the game has lost its rhythm. There's nothing really to talk about in the second half, except for that goal that Sergi by God, which was probably a defensive blunder by Highlanders. But this second half has got nothing really to write home about.
Yes, now Amazulu try to clear, and Highlanders get a free kick just outside the penal box. And it looks like just still shouting, just to signal that they want to make a change. And it's going to be James Piri. So James Piri going out and Gift Zawan who comes in. That substitution.
Yeah, Mozi, I think that is on tactical reasons. That, you know, they've already scored the goal. And probably, you know, what Highlanders will do will be desperate to try and get an equalizer. And they want to try now and play the game into Highlanders' half, so that Highlanders is kept in their own half. I think that's the main reason why, you know, they substituted a midfielder for a striker.
A good move as well.
You can see Gilbert is very, very nervous now. You know, that's a sign of desperation. He is making a blunder. He made the first blunder in the first half where he lets the player cross the ball and just wait by to get the ball to hit on him or whatever. He is not going on to get onto the player and stop the player from making the move. As you can see again, that is the same blunder that he has made now. He has let the ball go in front of him to an opponent in order for the opponent to put that final pass. It did not been for good defense work from the other player, from the other colleagues. It would have been the second goal now.
Amazulu coming through there and the timely challenge there coming from Beck Tembandovu. And now Amazulu searching ahead, looking for that second goal. And that's the kind of defensive work that they can come up with. Attack and attack. Now using three strikers, Sergi Baisendaka, Gift Zawanu, and Nomen Komani. Now they prepare to take the corner kick with Foster Chitema. Cleared away by Highlanders for a throw-in this time to Amazulu, and behind it is Master Masiko. This time Amazulu camping as Foster Chitema controls, trying to beat Thomas Banda, but Banda has defended as now Ronald Sivanda tries to win that one. Machindalo is it back, looking there for Zawanu, turning very well, still gives Zawanu. And that one will be a goal kick now to Highlanders as time is ticking away for Highlanders, but ticking in the right way for Amazulu as they race to that championship, which will be their first one since they came into the Premier League. And if they win this one, I'm sure they would have made life a lot easier. They would just release all the pressure that has been mounting on them, as now Gift Lunga throws. Looking there for Thamsang Avunda, Choruma now with a back pass, finding Gift Lunga. Ona Kombani, Beck Tembankiwane with the clearance. They are now looking for Thamsang Avunda. The goalkeeper is off his line, and Estron Yandoro has defended well. Beck Tembankiwane now with the big pass, finding Tapua Kapi. Kapini now for Highlanders, urging his men to move forward, but Amazulu now closing every single gap. As now it falls on Thompson Mavunda. His shot was a poor one. Safely collected by goalkeeper Dominic Sitole. Gilbert Banda has won it again. Flights in the cross. And it's headed away. Falls on Kombani, has it forward. Amazulu put in defense as they clear it forward again. The strike force again for Highlanders fading there.
Yes, Muzi, you can see Thompson is struggling a little bit, you know, in that accurate finishing. It will take some time for him to get into the match. I think personally this was not the game for him to be brought in. You know, this game was very crucial. That, you know, they needed players that have been playing and the players that, you know, combined well. You can see Thompson is struggling a little bit, you know, in that accurate finishing. It will take some time for him to get into the match. I think personally this was not the game for him to be brought in. You know, this game was very crucial. That, you know, they needed players that have been playing and the players that, you know, combined well. Other than just bringing the player, because they need to introduce a new striker into the game.
And now it looks like Highlanders will be making a double change. They are now taking out Thomas Banda, and they are now introducing Chumayeli Moyo and Costa Marazike. Highlander going out and just waiting to confirm the second player who will be going out. A bit of disapproval from the Highlanders fans there.
Gift Junior.
Looks like it's Gift Lunga will be going out. And those changes again, now they've taken out Thomas Banda and Gift Lunga, bringing in Costa and Chumay.
Well, look, personally, I believe in the move for Costa to come in. I think it's a very good move because he's a seasoned player, very experienced, and gets vital goals. But I think probably, you know, they've brought the strikers too late. And I think now hiring the strikers is very weak. The chances of getting that equalizer are now getting slimmer and slimmer.
Very weak, like we did say that on paper the Amazulu strike force looked the better one there. Vivian had the option of introducing Gift Zawanu as they break there again, Amazulu, but this time Highlanders clear it, and here now is Costa Marazike coming in as a substitute. He has also not featured in the last few games for Highlanders due to an injury, and coming in now, Foster Chitema now controls. And they push it forward. Victor Love will push that one back to Tapua Kapini. Kapini now with the long clearance is headed away by Ferdinand Machindalo, the Zambian, for Amazulu for a throw-in. So Amazulu looks like we'll be breaking that tradition of Highlanders always winning the second leg encounter of this Bulawayo derby, as they are leading here by 1-0. Chumaili Moyo now, second half substitute, finding Ona Kombani, turning very well as he lays it now for Choruma, but is taken away by Amazulu. Although Ona Kombani is fighting for that one, here is Maradzike now, the touch there. Foster Chitema is ruled to have come with a rough challenge. That's a free kick now to Highlanders on the right flank, and it looks like Ronald Zimanda is just indicating that he would like to be substituted, just signaling there that he would like to be substituted. Does it happen that a player on the field at times requests to be substituted?
Yes, Moses, it's quite normal. You know, the player feels that he has given all what he's got, and he'll be disadvantaging the other players if he keeps on, you know, just playing for the sake of just playing. You know, it's normal that the player would ask to request to be substituted for many other reasons anyway.
We'll wait to see if the coaching department will follow the request as Highlanders try to break through, and that ball just goes out for a throw-in. So Amazulu still holding on here, and if they can get these 3 points, it will be a great favor for themselves for the championship. As they break again on the counter, they find Sergio by Sandaka, but this time is ruled offside. But the counter-attack working very well for Highlanders, as rather for Amazulu, as we confirm there that booking for Foster Chitema. The counter by Amazulu working well.
Yes, Muzi, the reason being that, you know, Highlanders has had so many substitutes, new players on the pitch. You know, the rhythm has gone down, and of course, it is normal that Amazulu would have to capitalize on this and you know, have those counters. So when Highlanders are still trying to get their rhythm.
And they're just confirming those substitutes. Them, Chumaili Moyo for Costa Maratike, as now Highlanders trying to build an attack. The cross comes through from Ona Kombani, is cleared away. Still falls on Kiwane, finding now Costa Maratike. He will fight the cross. He's headed away by Herbert Dick. Chumaili Moyo now pushes it to Costa Maratike, and Herbert Dick in defense for Amazulu has been outstanding all afternoon, coming with those good clearances, as now they try to surge forward, and surge by Sandaka was always closing in. Now Stamson Mavunda, as he flies in the cross, Dominic Sitole collects for Amazulu. Master Masiku through a ball now looking there for Nomen Kumar. one, and that's cleared away by Highlanders. Choruma picks it now for Highlanders. It's another blind pass, and Gabini now is off his goal area as he comes with the clearance. And Master Masiku also pushes it out. Some scrappy play at this stage, but Amazulu will be saying we've got the goal.
Yes, Muzi, as I said, that, you know, the second half has nothing really to offer, you know. And as you can see, it's blunder after blunder. There's not really the team that really this game deserves in the second half. And if the play continues to be like this, I mean, it's good enough for Amazulu, but not good enough for the man that has paid the hard-earned money to come and watch, you know, the best of the Blauwe Giants, you know what I mean?
So it's just now 7 minutes before full time. 7 minutes for Amazulu to hold on for a good 3 points. 3 points that will take them to the top of the log, and still having two games in hand. And if they are to win those two games in hand, Costa Maratica with the cross is headed away. It falls on Vectembandog with the cross, comes through. They've missed that one. It comes again now to Gilbert Banda. Brings in the cross. It's headed away. And it comes now again to Chumail Moyo. And the referee says that's a free kick to Highlanders. And a handshake there coming from Ronald Sibanda to Chumail Moyo. It's Amazulu 1, Highlanders 0, and we have 5 minutes before full time. 5 minutes for Amazulu to keep the lead and pick up 3 valuable points, and that should be a bookable offensive from Bektemba Nkiwane there on Norman Komane. So just under 5 minutes before full time. It looks like Amazulu have got the 3 points, and these will be crucial 3 points, unless if Highlanders can come up with a miracle in the dying moments.
Well, the saying is still the same, Mozi, that you never say it's over until the final whistle. But look, time is ticking away from Highlanders, and Amazulu, they really, really, really need these points, and they really need to be the champions once for the time in history. So, really, time is ticking away. Amazulu are wasting time because they know that they've got a goal. And for Highlanders, it's just about fighting until the final whistle.
And the news we are getting from the capital at Rufaro Stadium is that Chapungu are leading Dynamos by 2-1. It's Chapungu 2, Dynamos 1. And here it's Highlanders 0, Amazulu 1. So this is good news indeed for Amazulu, as they will open up an impressive lead at the top of the log over Dynamos and Highlanders, the teams that have been chasing them. And it looks like now everything is very much in favor of Amazulu, unless if they are to falter in their remaining games. But at this stage, they've done the basics, as now Kokeli was breaking loose there, and a free kick to Amazulu. But the scoreline coming from Rufaro, Dynamo going down by 2-1, and this will mean that it's now good for Amazulu.
Obviously, Amazulu now, if getting these 3 points here and winning the two remaining games, it's it works well for Amazulu. As you say, that unless otherwise, no, they give away the other two games in hand. It's not over until, you know, they get to play those two games in hand. They might get beaten by those other two games and still Highlanders in the run. So they have to make sure that, you know, the two games in hand, they have to win them, or at least get 4 points out of those the two games.
It's something that they can try and achieve, as Highlanders now pick it up with Choruma. Choruma now finding Gilbert Banda. Choruma with a through ball now to Kombani. Choruma now trying to break there. And that's a fun. And Thabua Kabini seeing a Peter Schmeichel exit.
Yeah, okay, fine. He's showing the true dedication, you know, from a player. And you can see that he's actually even putting
much more dangerous balls than the inside players. You know, every ball that he touches is actually being a threat to Amazulu. But unfortunately, time has gone.
Yes, and seeing some creativity, perhaps they might consider drafting him into the midfield department for next season, seeing his creativity. And he has gone again for the goal. The crowd enjoy it as they cheer him on, as he tries to get that goal for Highlanders. That is Tabua Kabini. It's Amazulu 1, Highlanders 0. The corner kick comes over. He's far away from it. And now Thompson Mafunda lays it. And is cleared away again by Amazulu, doing well. Richard Choruma now. It comes again. Tabua Kabini is in there. Costa Marazzi again. Highlanders have got the equalizer! With Thabo Kabini in the box there, creating commotion. It's in Kokeri Thube. And Highlanders are still in the running for the championship.
I told you, Musi, I said, you know, it's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Marvelous performance from the Highlanders goalkeeper. Marvelous performance from this goalkeeper. You will never believe it. You never, never believe it. I told you, it's never over until the final whistle. And should you have any more 5-10 minutes and Kabini continues to play like this, you will be a true hero for Highlanders supporters. It's never over until the final whistle.
Well, I can't believe it. I can't believe it indeed. Highlanders have got the equalizer here in a scramble for possession. The goalkeeper, Thabua Kabini, was in there. They just forced it. And Amazulu always disappoints towards the end of the goal. I thought they had the 3 points wrapped up. But now the final games, the two games in hand that they have, will be crucial. They'll need to win those ones. And the rest for the championship is not yet over. A bit of excitement as some soccer fans rolled onto the pitch, and look at that immaculate mask there as Baba Cruz Stadium has erupted.
It's actually like you've gone to the grave and brought up the dead from the rise from the dead. Everybody now is live again. Islanders might, if Amazon are not here, the next last minute, Highlanders might grab another goal. Because as you can see, I don't know what has transpired in there, but you can see that even the